Hey, it's Eric here. Let's go ahead and talk about the basics of looks in Scratch. So as you can see in our scene here, we have a hayfield backdrop and we have Nano, who is probably arguably the best looking sprite in Scratch. So I chose Nano, and let's see what look blocks we can use to start manipulating the looks. So we see on the top here, we have say hello for 2 seconds. So let's go ahead and preview this block. And okay, yeah, we see it's sort of like a cartoon. So we have a little thought bubble, or rather the speech bubble there. So we can change to whatever we want. So hi, I am Nano. And again, I'm just previewing this. I won't bother to put it in the scripts area. So say hi, I'm Nano for 2 seconds. There we go. Cool. Okay, and we see here's one, say hello. Similar, just no time. And likewise, we have the think, for 2 seconds. So we'll go ahead and preview this. And there we go. It's more of a thought bubble instead of a speech bubble. So obviously, you know, these four would be in handy if you're doing a story in Scratch and you want to have the character say something. So I really enjoy these four blocks. Moving on, we have the show and hide block. So these should seem pretty obvious as well. The show block and the hide block are going to enable you to manipulate whether you want to see or not see the sprite. So we'll go ahead and test this one out. Hide. So when green flag is clicked, we're going to hide the sprite. So there you go. Nano disappeared, which is unfortunate, so let's go ahead and bring him back, or her back. Go ahead, hit the green flag, so there we go. These will come in handy later on when you start to build more complex sequences, so maybe at a certain point in the game you want a sprite to disappear, or you're telling a story and you want, you know, a sprite to disappear. These can really come in handy. Let's go ahead and ignore these for a second, but rather jump down to the change size. So we know that we can use these tools up here to change the size of the sprite, right? So if we want to make Nano bigger, we can go ahead and click him and make him bigger. Likewise, we can make him smaller. But say we want to sort of make these automated, right? And we want the size to change by 10% somewhere within the game, right? So we'll go ahead. I'm going to turn on the size here using the checkbox so we can monitor the size. So we see the size right now is 95. And we'll use the change size by 10 block. So I can go ahead, if I attach this, when green flag is clicked, change size by 10. So let's see what happens to the size. Ah, there we go. We see we got bigger by 10. Likewise, we can do smaller by, let's say, 5. So we'll go ahead. When green flag is clicked, smaller. So pretty cool. Pretty useful block. Likewise, we have the set size. So if we want to set the size at the beginning, so we want to make the Nano really small. So 50%. So we'll see his size will be set to 50%. There we are. So that's really cool. I like that, hanging out by the haystack. So we skipped the costumes, but I say we do that right now. Let's go ahead and look at this switch costume to Nano D. So we see in this drop-down menu, we have all the different costumes that are associated with this sprite. So we see, we'll make our sprite actually a little bit bigger so we can see the different costumes. Okay. Now we can choose from this drop-down menu. So we have costume A, B, C, and D. You're probably thinking, well, Eric, what are these costumes? Well, when you choose a sprite from your library, you know, we can see that each sprite has a number of costumes with it. Actually, some have no costumes, but some have multiple. Some have 2, 3, and 4. So we chose Nano, who had 4 costumes, and if we want to see what these costumes look like, we can quickly click the costumes tab. And there you go, we see costume A, B, C, and D. So pretty adorable, as I said. So let's say we want to switch the costume to costume B. So go ahead, hit the green flag. And there you go. So we can switch costumes at this, you know, the drop of a hat by using this one. Also, we have the option to, you know, just change to the next costume here. So if we don't really have an order in particular, we don't want it to go from A to C, just to go A, B, C, D, we can click, you know, next costume, next costume, next costume. So again, you'll find this useful when you're creating those more complex scenes.